Well, I came back to the Latir Wilderness, the Latir Mountain Wilderness Trail, without my partner Josie, my little dog. Wanted to do it, try to get the whole 12 point some odd miles of it walked today, and take some photographs along the way. And as far as my YouTube channel, and you know, my homestead and everything, it's still in the process of doing. I'm having some governmental bureaucratic hang-ups and stuff that is, I guess, fairly normal, and I don't really want to go into it. It's boring. But the government fucks everything up. I'll say that and leave it at that. Anyway, I've made the climb up this thing up into here with my truck already, so I took a few pictures, and I'll, you know, include them in the whole thing of the climb up, and go ahead and get started with this hike. Okay, here I am. I'm up here by the lake at the start of the trail, as you can see. I'm going to turn the camera around and kind of film a little bit as I go along the way on the trail. Anyway, hope you guys enjoy. Thank you. Stop and put my hoodie on. It's starting to get really chilly up here, at least for my southern blood. I want to say it's 61 degrees in Taos today. That's at much lower elevation. I want to say we're probably at I'm guessing at about 9,000 some odd feet here. Anyway, may end up at around 12 or so. But anyway, I'm gonna keep going, and hell, I just got started. Still by the lake, anyway, here goes.
Exist without the dark. Thank you.
Hey guys, I've already stopped and had me a little snack and some water, and I'm up here, and as you can see, there's a lot of snow on the trail, and it's making it a little bit harder to walk. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to kind of put the camera away for a little bit until I get up a little bit higher and see some more pretty scenery, which this is pretty, but you know, you've already seen it, so I'm gonna wait till I get up a little bit farther. Like I said, just give you a surround sound. I'm on a surround view. I'm on a log right here with my stick and my tripod, my little aluminum tripod that I've been using to carry the camera, but I'm gonna put the camera into my bag for right now, into my backpack, so I can wrestle with this trail till it gets a little bit easier, or I just see something just stupendous. All right, guys, I've already decided I'm not gonna do the whole trail today. It's close to 13 miles long, and I'm not that far into it really, and it's already challenging, and this trail goes all the way up into the mountains. I'm gonna go as far as I can today and hopefully get some really cool pictures, and this is gonna have to be one I tackle in a couple days, and the next time I come out I'm gonna bring a tent, because it may take me a couple days to do, because I'm a novice at trail hiking. I'm a Mississippi boy, you know, I'm a southern boy. I'm used to flat trails with no snow. And this one is really savage, really, for me. And the funny thing about it is the trails around here where I'm living now goes all the way up to hard. This is a moderate trail. There's easy, moderate, and hard. So maybe I should have started on an easy trail, but nah, fuck that. I like to start above my, you know, grade and graduate into it. The first time I came out here, I bought my little Yorkie with me, and this trail's too wild for her, because she's just such a small dog. There's wild animals out here. I'm not gonna do that to her. Anyway, let me show you. I'm at a place where the stream that flows down into that lake meets down with the trail, instead of the trail being above it. It's really cool. And this is just really rad. Anyway, I'm gonna eat me another little snack, drink me some water, and continue on up the trail as far as I can. But I gotta leave enough time for me to walk back to my truck, you know. Peace. If the earth is not alive, then neither am I. And as you can see, the earth is alive. Alright, I've decided to start filming again since the trail seems a little bit more clear. It's still steep as fuck. I'm getting steeper, but with the snow, it makes it a lot easier. Well, without the snow, rather. Maybe I spoke too soon. We'll see. Seems like it all depends on the slope of the trail. If it flattens out, there's more snow. This ain't so bad.
It's so pleasant up here. Damn it, rocks. About the time I fucking shoot. Hey guys, I'm a little out of breath here. You hear that? Stream? That tranquil as fuck. I'm way the fuck up here, but nowhere near deep into it. I checked my position on the GPS as far as the next closest neat little thing on the trail is a place called Heart Lake. It's another lake. I'm not gonna be able to conquer this one today, but I'm gonna go for another half an hour. There's a ridge up there I really would like to at least get up to and take a good photo of, if not get on top of it. Looks like a spire from here, I don't know. Can't really tell through the trees. Whew, but I am not in New Mexico shape. So, you know, and I will get there. This is very challenging for me, and I really appreciate a challenge. I'm just taking a break by this stream because I love the sound of it. I'd love to come out here with my Tascam recorder and just capture a bunch of these different sounds to put behind some of my music. I heard a sound back there just a little bit. I thought it might have been a bear, but turns out it was a bird. Back in a bunch of fell trees. May have a nest up in there somewhere. I'm hearing a lot of them out here though. I'm not even sure what kind of bird. I just love these little streams though. That, I don't know if you could see that, I'm trying to aim it toward a stream. But it just comes down the mountain from snow melt or something and feeds that humongous creek that flows down into the lake. It's pretty neat. I'm pretty impressed. Anyway, I continue on. I just took a couple pictures of this little tiny waterfall of this little brook. Very nice. I had to work with my camera for a little bit because the lens has gotten snagged. Anyway, yeah, pretty fucking cool. Yeah, I've decided to go ahead and stop here, turn around. It took me 2 hours to get to this point. And next time I come out to this particular trail, I'm gonna plan on conquering the whole thing, even if it takes me a couple days or more. Which means I'll be staying out here in the wilderness overnight, which is cool. But yeah, this seems like a good stopping point because I'm kind of tired of crossing things like this anyway, and by the time I get back to the truck, it'll be around 4. And that'll leave me time enough to go into town, maybe get some dinner and whatnot, before heading back out to my RV. I would keep going, but I had no plans for spending the night out here. I would have made other arrangements otherwise. But I'll be conquering another trail soon. I'm going to pick one that's shorter. Probably one that either goes down into the rim, you know, the gorge, or one up here across in the, from the town of Red River, heading up into the mountains, similar to this, but a lot shorter and rated a little bit easier of a trail. We'll see. But starting tomorrow, I'm going to be pretty busy doing business, homestead business. It's kind of boring. And if there's anything exciting, I'll film it, but, you know, getting permits and shit like that is rather boring and rather pointless in a free world. That's why we're not free, man. Anyway, I'll talk with you guys later. I'm heading back. Taking a little water break on the way back. Figured I'd take a big prolonged break this time since I'm on my way out of here anyway. It's a very pleasant sound. I'm sitting here kind of on the side of the trail. I'm gonna try to turn this around. So you see, I'm looking downhill. Across the way is another mountain. What up? I think it's called Baldy Peak or something like that up there. Anyway, let's turn this back around. I came up with some ideas, and you know, while I was on this hike today, and about write some new material. That thing I said back earlier in the video, if the earth is not alive, then neither am I. This water is the earth's blood. Thawing out, flowing down, filling the streams, watering the crops, all that stuff, you know. You know, I don't want to be too preachy, but anyway. It's just, I've been on a spiritual path, I guess you could say, since my wife was killed. It's led me to this point and further on to realize, you know, that we're not even real. Our identities, our egos, we're just as much part of this earth as we are who we are. God, that fucking hurt. A little sticker stick coming out of the ground. Shit, that fucking hurt. Anyway, it's kind of why I want to be more out here than in cities anymore. And I'm a city boy. I lived in Atlanta for a long time, and that's where the wreck happened. And ever since then, I just don't want to be there. And over any city, even small towns, I'd rather be out here. Nothing wrong with big cities in and of themselves, you know. It's just not, it's not who I am anymore. Yeah, and it's all good. This video, let me get to that. This video is going up on YouTube, and I'm going to share it on my Facebook group, which is growing and doing pretty good as far as I'm concerned, you know. And my Facebook channel, my YouTube channel's not. Of course, I pay more attention to my music than I do it anyway. But I want people who are watching this video to go and subscribe to my channel, my Watcher and Wanderer channel on YouTube. I want to grow this audience, and, you know, I don't really know to what end, you know. just sharing. And it goes back to what I just said about the Earth and the universe and us being one. Really, it's true, and the internet shows that, proves it, if you think about it. Everybody shares, just like I'm sharing this video here, everybody shares everything that they do, instantly almost. Now, with live videos, it's instantaneous, and I've done that, but of course, I don't have a signal up here, so I have to pre-record, but I'm still sharing it with you. So it's like everything, practically everything that is being experienced is being shared by people. And that's my kind of philosophy. The only thing that's real is experience. That's the only thing that's real. It's the whole, the tree falls in the forest and nobody hears that it really happened. It's kind of like that. You know, the happening of it, the experiencing of it, that's all we are. We're just God's eyes experiencing the universe. And when I say God, I'm not talking about a particular religion. I'm not religious. I'm talking about the universe itself. It's God. It is. Argue with me about Jesus, Allah, or who the fuck ever, but at the end of the day, the sun, the moon, the stars, the earth, the water, the mountains, the trees, the deserts, swamps, all that shit, that's the only thing that's divine. That's it. And that's why I'm trying to experience things like this. Instead of bullshit desires that some, most of the time do not do you any good. Yeah. Anyway, at the end of the day, all we have is ourselves and this wonderful universe that we live in, which is a peaceful thing in and of itself. People make it bad. People make it hard. People do shitty things. Egos do shitty things. Anyway, I'm gonna drink me some water and get back on this trail. I don't know if I'm gonna holler back at you or not.